London Road, 423 London Road, cross street of Bower Road and Fritzhoff Drive. And map page 47, section 9, map page 47, section 9. They made a Winter Park Time subdivision. Flight Orange County, pass 3 for a readback.
My name is Scott McCauley. I'm a firefighter for the city of Winter Park. I've been there for just under 2 years, about a year and 8 months. I like the camaraderie that basically the family you become. So you live with these guys for a 30-year life, so you inevitably become a family. Pulling in, it's just getting ready for work. Another day at the office. I get here at 7 in the morning. It's a 24-hour shift, so it's from 7 a.m. to 7 a.m. every third day. So every morning, go grab my gear, put it up in the truck where I'm gonna be. Have to go through everything, make sure it's all there, it all works correctly. Got little name tags. Put on a board here, it's called a passport. It says the engine or rescue or truck, who's on it. It's basically for accountability purposes. If there's no calls going on, there's always something to be done, whether we come up with some kind of training or tidy something up or fix something. There's always something to be done around the station.
So it was a false alarm?
Yeah, her medical alarm went off. There is a huge emphasis on physical training and being fit. And I mean, the main reason is it's a physical job. If you've got somebody who's not in shape, they might not be able to do whatever task presents itself.
Buckle you up there.
We have training mannequins. They're made for different reasons. We have one that is 185 pounds, and that's the mannequin we use for doing our fire training mainly, because it's around an average weight of a normal person.
Get him back any way you can. Get him up on the curb. There you go. He's saved.
If we get a call, we'll hear it over the speakers. We listen to see who's going. Once we figure out who's going, everybody goes to the unit they're on. The quicker everybody gets on the vehicle, the quicker we can get to wherever the patient is. We do have a time frame, but you want to waste as little time as you can. When we're going to a call. We're getting whatever information dispatch can give us from the caller themselves. Depending on what the call is, it'll kind of depend on where our mindset is. If it's a medical call, we get our mind prepared for a medical call. Depending on what it is, we'll kind of try to think ahead a little bit. And normally we have 60 seconds to put all the gear on, then another 60 seconds for the air pack and mask. And we're tested on it every year that we can do it in that amount of time.
In a fire situation, when we come in immediately, we're gonna ask if anyone's in the house. Fire department, anyone in here? We'll sound off real loud, and then what happened, we'll just go through and continue on with our search. We're trying to find the fire or the victim.
Everybody has an emergency, and everybody needs some help at some point. Somebody's gotta do it, and most of the people that do it because they love to do it. To me, it's not really much of a risk. It's not a risk. There's times where people have been killed doing what I do and in this profession, but the thought never crosses my mind whether I'm gonna get hurt or killed in there. It's not on my mind. What's going through my mind is whatever my job's gonna be, that's what I need to do. So if I'm the guy with the hose on the nozzle and my job is to put out the fire, the only thing going through my mind at that point is find the fire and put it out. The call is a priority. Nothing comes above the call.